Did you hear that?
Yeah, I heard it, and Cindy has gone crazy. Over.
Dragon man.
Oh.
Sharpening a blade.
All right, there are going to be dragon people like half.
There are dragonborns, yeah. Mm.
Okay, now we attack.
A dragon destroyed my village when I was a girl. Destroyed it, burned it to the ground. Everything, everyone I cared about.
I'm sorry to hear that, but bad things happen.
With dragons.
And he falls to his knees, helpless. His swords clatter to his sides. Well, you're all surrounding him. He ain't doing anything. And there's a sleeping old man.
So you all have a minute left in the sleep spell that Hesla Sarker put out. This is 30 seconds. So two flips of this, and then who knows what happens.
So a real-time minute.
You have a real-time minute to decide what's going on.
No pressure.
Do they kill this guy, the half-dragon? Do they try to kill the Sarker again? Whatever. You have a minute. I'm not going to listen to you bicker about it for 5 minutes to tell me what you did in a minute's time. You've got a minute. Go.
I want to tie him up. I have rope.
Okay.
I'm right there.
All right,
so
let's
I want to tie up. Well, I've only got it. I'm over there. You're okay. Over there. I'm tying up Le Sarker.
All right.
So, got my rope.
Let's
tie up his hands behind his back.
He is magical, though, right?
He is magical, but you have to, depending on the spell, you have to be able to move your hands. So I'm tying his hands behind his back.
Got it. Maybe you should gag him, too.
Gag him, okay. Just in case. So, I'm going to gag him and tie him up. What are you going to do with the dragon guy? I'm also going to tie his feet.
I'm tying him up. I'll tie
I'm going to blindfold him, also.
He says to you, that's not necessary. I've given up.
Okay, so I'm tying up Lasarker. Feet.
He can't see, he can't talk, he can't move.
Arm behind his back. Gagged.
I'm tying him up.
Blindfolded.
Should I put stuff in his ears so he can't hear us? I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna
gagging the dragon. How do you put something in his ears?
I don't know. That would be gross.
Just stand behind him and go.
Alright. Shush, shush, shush.
Alright, he's tied up, that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Alright, so they're both tied up and gagged and stuff.
Bound, gagged, sensory deprived.
Yeah. Just how we like them.
Dudes.
Just how we like them.
All right. So we did that.
I like my men like I like my coffee.
What?
Sensory deprived.
I don't get it.
No, neither do I. That's an old Eddie Izzard joke. So he's like, I like my men like I like my coffee. Covered in bees. Sorry, it's an Eddie Izzard. Look him up. He's great.
What? Who?
Eddie Izzard?
That's
not a joke. His joke was, like my woman like I like my coffee with a spoon in it.
Well, he has one where he's a beekeeper. Later on in that same thing, he's talking about people who are beekeepers, and he didn't understand beekeepers. They like everything covered in bees. They're like, I like my coffee. Covered in bees! It's really funny.
Very good.
It
doesn't seem that funny.
He's hilarious.
Generational gap, kids.
Yes.
The old man starts to come too. Braktha is like, he was basically telling her this isn't necessary, but she bound and gagged him anyways.
I'm sorry, but I can't let you do any more harm to the people I care about. I can't risk it.
He's gagged, I guess, so he can't
they
really
can't
talk.
Say anything.
Yeah.
You know what? Braktha, sorry, but bear with us until we figure this out, but.
I want to investigate the painting behind them.
Alrighty. Well, you look behind, there's nothing on it, or nothing behind it. You can't tell any magic.
Are her eyes shifting with
no.
us?
No. She's watching us.
That would be so creepy.
Not a Scooby-Doo episode.
Lasarker's awake at this point?
Yes.
Okay. He's not really doing anything? He's just kind of like...
He's not struggling.
Has he really...
hasn't really done anything
so far.
So I'm gonna ask Malkos.
Yes.
Malkos, what we should do now? What do you want to do? Do you want to take this painting?
Yeah.
Okay.
We take the painting and go.
Okay, let's do it.
All right.
I'm gonna get this side. You get that side. Let's take it down.
I'll grab the painting.
I think we should figure out what's going on here with Lasarker before we just leave.
Why?
Because. One, this is his prized possession. You don't think he's going to come after us if we take it?
Yeah, I don't really think I would want that painting right now. It's like putting a target right in the middle of your back.
I feel that we should figure out what's going on here before we just leave.
How do you want to do that?
I say we missed a whole bunch of... There is obviously more of the...
There are other rooms that we have not
I say someone should... maybe pairs, watch him.
I don't think we should. I don't know if we should split the groups.
We have, all right, then. All
right. At this point, Bracta goes, Can we
ask him?
Yeah.
Let's talk to him.
I'm changing the voice because I'm sick. But, okay. Yeah, allergies are killing me. So I thought I could still work my way through it. I've only been suffering with this for 5 days. Surely I must be over it. Not quite. As long as they edit out all my hacking and coughing, I'm good. Okay. Thank you. Uh-huh.
It's pretty close, actually.
No, the other one was like, thank you. I can't do it.
Whoa.
That's all right, yeah.
What are you doing?
There it is.
That's what we're trying to figure out, Bracta.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's what we're trying to figure out.
I feel like Malkos should answer him. Mm-hmm. So you're doing both voices.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. Talking back.
Can you totally talk to yourself
one
for
guy yeah. play.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're just going to sit here and watch.
All right. So we're taking this painting because it's worth a lot of money. It is worth a lot of money. You guys suck.
You're doing great. Keep it up.
It's worth more than money. It's worth everything. A bite? What do you mean? I hate you all.
I really, really hate you.
All the things the Lazarker possesses, he bought or won from the Sinister Swap. Including my life. Except that painting.
A sinister swap?
Can you define sinister swap for me? I really didn't know. My first thought was that like there's some like, I don't know, an evil swap meet out in somebody's backyard where they set up little tents and there's all these like bad guys with hoods saying like, I've got this thing, what do you wanna do?
That would be a fun place to go.
I thought like it was something like sold his soul to a dark deity to have all these things.
People like spitting in each other's mouth.
Sinister swap. There are 7 of them. 7 collectors who meet every year. They each take a priceless item. And whoever has the best one takes them all.
So the 7 evil dudes just exchanging evil things. Sounds like a fun place to be.
So he owns you?
It is what it is. I could do nothing about it. When I did do something about it, every member of my lineage mysteriously disappeared.
So you're the last of your family is what you're telling us.
Now I am, yes.
So the Sarker is not a nice guy.
No.
Do you want us to kill him?
I wish you luck. I have not been able to.
So you've tried?
I tried once. And then everyone died.
That's a
bummer. Wow, okay. When is this next sinister swap happening?
Well, he just had one a month ago.
So it's going to be a while.
Going to be a while.
So how did he get a hold of the painting of the woman if he didn't get it with the swap?
I don't know. He had that before I was here. But he's never taken it to the sinister swap. Even though it would nearly guarantee him a win.
Why? What's so special about this painting?
It's the last painting of Lafont.
The last painting.
I am intrigued by the rest of the house.
Yeah.
The Sarker doesn't really seem to care about us right now because he's just kind of sitting there like...
I think he knows we're not really a threat to him.
It appears that way. Yeah. Now, sidebar, I'm feeling bad for Bracta. I would like to help him because this dude's been enslaved and his entire family killed because of this guy.
The full background is Bracta actually had a friend who invited him to a party. And turns out this party was the sinister swap. So this friend actually like called him a possession all of a sudden and ended up losing that year to Lazarker.
So, Dragon Lady?
You're right, he's been...
But he's a dragon. Or part dragon.
Do you overcome your fear of dragons a little bit?
I think that we should help Rakva. He's been unfairly enslaved, and he tried to do what was right, and his family got murdered for it. So let's help.
We've talked about it. The situation is bad. None of us think this is okay. We want to help you through this. If we untie you, will you promise to not attack us?
Well, I would be dead if not for your mercy. Okay. So I promise not to attack.
Okay.
When he is free, I will be dead.
Okay, so there's nothing we can do to prevent that from happening?
I'll help you do whatever we can do.
But you don't know of anything?
Besides killing him, I do not.
And we don't know how to kill him.
Nope.
Would you say he's a bad dude?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I think we need to untie Rakva.
Okay.
And I think you should untie him as a symbol of good faith. Just like... I really wanted Abby to be the one to set Rakva free. She has always had just this really confrontational thing with anything related to dragons. But now in this situation where she's realizing that this guy was actually held prisoner, his entire family was killed, he's a slave. There's not black and white.
I'm going to come up to him and I'm going to look into his eyes and I'm going to say, dragons destroyed everything, but you didn't. It wasn't you, and I'm not going to punish you for my life being destroyed by someone else.
Sweet.
I will help you, and then I'm going to untie him like this.
Excellent.
Fluffy there for Abby right now. I'm feeling like, oh.
Yeah, I love that Mark had her free him, because it's like I'm forcing your character to grow to accept that not all dragons are evil. And it could be this guy actually was evil, but, you know, they had a pretty good feeling about him. And so she's going to take the emotional step she needed to let it go a little bit. Started getting watery, and I realized it was my allergies. It made me sad because I still have allergies. I started getting watery again. It's a very emotional moment for me.
All right, so Rakva?
That was way better than I thought it was going to be. Hieronius, give me the strength.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that was really good. That was
really excellent.
That was really good. I actually felt a little chill right there.
Mm-hmm. All right, Rakva is free.
Yay, Rakva is free.
He bows to you.
Have you ever left the grounds or tried to leave the grounds?
I've left the grounds.
Okay, so you're not going to like spontaneously combust when you leave the gates.
Now, I feel like there's a lot of stuff that we have not learned about this place because we didn't get... to any
yeah,
of these
there
other
are lots of
parts
rooms.
Of the places over here. Mm-hmm. I think we should investigate for sure, but I don't want to leave the Lasarker here by himself. I mean, should we like drag Lasarker along with us?
Stonen, just put him over his shoulder.
Totally good.
Okay, let's do that.
All right.
Let's do that. Stone throws him over the shoulder.
Sure, sure.
So, come along with us. We discover the secret to killing you.
Well, I mean, is there another option? Do we...
No, it's just kind of funny.
It is kind of funny.
Well, I think we've learned from past experiences that you should probably look through the rooms before you leave.
I mean, Brack, there's nobody else in here, right?
In that room? No.
In the... building, in the manor, in the...
Oh, yeah, there is.
Oh, yeah, where are all the guards? There are all the guards on the
outside. He has hunters everywhere. You saw the beasts in his game room.
Yeah.
He retained the hunters that caught each of them.
Oh, so they're still here.
Yes.
Solid. Great!
Oh.
So we need to figure out
what's the deal with those beasts? Are they petrified, or...?
He has them magically triggered to do things throughout the house.
Be more specific.
Beholder, okay. He can see everything because that eye stalk goes in every room.
But is it only if he's in that room can he see what the beholder sees? Or
yeah, in this particular
room. So if we take him out of the room, then...
He does not have that particular ability.
How loyal are these hunters to Lasarker?
Pretty loyal. They get paid very well to kill. So they do what they want, and they get money for it.
So if we come in with Lasarka over our shoulder, are they going to be like, no, don't hurt him? Or are they going to be like,
They're
going to
kill on sight.
I only have one spell slot left and 11 hit points, people.
Wonderful.
Three spells.
We could put him in the pantry.
Right? We know that room.
We could.
I know that room very well.
You do. Yes. And you guys have a bunch of food.
But if we left him in the pantry, one of his hunters could find him and untie him, and then we'd have to deal with him some more.
We could lock the pantry door.
I'm more concerned with getting hit points and spell slots back. But are we going to be safe in here for a few hours?
I don't think so.
I feel like they're all figuring out a way to come to us.
Surely they have to have some kind of patrol or something throughout this.
But are they going to come in his special room?
Yeah, do the hunters come into his office?
The hunters do not. I am the only one who enters his office.
Is there a closet in this room?
No.
Would we be safe to rest here for a while?
I guess as safe as any room in this chateau.
So it's a hidden doorway. Can we, like, block the door and secure our place in here so that we can rest and recover?
That would be good.
I think we should do that, because we need to rest and get spell slots back.
With watches.
With watches, yeah. We've gone through all of these battles with Brokthe and Lasarker. I've used all my freaking spells. I'm really low on hit points. Good lord, Kira's always almost dead. So at some point, we've got to, like, recover this stuff. So yeah, I thought we needed to rest. And as weird as it may seem, the lair of Lasarker seems like the most secure place to rest.
And if Brokthe went about his, like, daily business, would the hunters believe you if you said, like, they're having a meeting, like, everything's okay?
That's a good idea.
Wait, Brokthe,
like if you went about and did your normal daily whatever you do during the day, and you're like, these people are okay, they're talking to Lasarka, would that hold everybody off for a little while?
Very, very likely.
I think that's a great idea.
Okay. I mean, do we trust him that much?
You know what? He's been upfront with us.
Okay.
So I think that we can take the risk.
Okay.
It's a super trusting move, sending out the guy he just about killed.
Since she believed that he was, you know, sort of enslaved and wasn't necessarily, it was of his will to be there or working for this guy, that she thought maybe they could use that to their advantage.
I was nervous about that because we just met the guy, number one. Number two, we almost killed him. So I don't know why he would be willing to help us. So I don't know. I really thought that he might go out and just be like, hey dudes, there's a group of people in this room that we probably want to kill.
Okay. So Brokthe, I mean, we did spare your life here. Didn't have to.
Our goal was to get you out of here.
We want to help you. We want to get you out of here, but we need your help. We need to rest. We need to recover a little bit. Can you run interference in the manor for us while we rest here?
I'll run through my daily duties.
Perfect. Love that. Duty. Can you come back in about 4 hours?
I'll do that.
That's happening. We're resting.
Rest, rest, rest.
So over the 4 hours, Malkos is pretty intently staring at that painting, trying to figure it out. I mean, he knows he wants it. It's a beautiful painting. It is one of the best paintings, if not the best painting you've ever seen. You don't know who the woman is. She doesn't even seem familiar, and yet she does. And he just can't really kind of take his eyes off it. He's pretty focused. Even Stonehand's like trying to joke with him, and he's all like, yeah, yeah. I'm staring at it.
Malkos, you okay over there?
Oh, I'm good.
You're good?
Well, are we getting this thing out of here?
Well, we'll come back for it, but we want to kind of look around the manor a little more.
Why?
I don't know.
Don't you want to see if there's any other treasure here?
There's plenty of treasure here, but there's also apparently 4 hunters.
That's true.
I don't want to be a coward or anything like that, but if we have the best treasure here, that might be the thing to take away.
We need to figure out our escape route first, and then see if we can afford to go anywhere else.
things. Are you worried about the repercussions of taking the painting?
No.
Really? This is a pretty powerful guy, apparently.
Yeah. So, I guess we should kill him first?
Well, we tried that.
The thing is, there isn't, we don't know a way to do that, so that's one of the reasons we're
So that's why we're here. Around, trying to figure out how to kill this guy.
I mean, yeah.
All right.
Well, I think I'm going to throw this out here. I think that the answer might be somewhere else in the manor. We've only looked through half of
that
this place.
That typically is the thing when there's this unkillable guy
killing death.
Everybody's
potions.
Got a weakness.
Usually somewhere
Everybody's
else.
Everybody's got a weakness.
Stone Ant staring off.
Got a potion room? Anybody?
Not the idea guy, but didn't he say we could see anywhere in the castle from here?
Oh, yeah. This is the Dungeon Master being like, you guys are stupid.
No, that's me just being
Oh, yeah, we're in
Stone
the
Ann.
Control room.
We're in the control room.
Okay, so all these little glass things all over the place, we can see all over the manor.
Okay.
So let's see if we can see these other rooms.
Yeah.
All right, so you see a bunch of like these little glass discs. You don't see anything through them, but... Maybe if you try doing something.
Correct? Do you know how these things work?
Oh, that's right. He came back.
He's like, oh,
yeah,
my
yeah. It's been 4 hours. He's here now.
He says, the master, excuse me, Lasarker. He just says the name of the room while touching certain discs and just gets to see what's in there.
Okay.
Do you know the names of all the rooms?
Don't touch them.
We don't know.
You did that on purpose.
Like room on the left. Yeah, can you help us with the names?
The game room, I know that one.
Okay, let's look in the game room.
I'm going to touch one of the little glass things. I'm going to say game room.
All right, so you see the room with the three stuffed monsters in it. And there is a guy patrolling in that room. He is a drow. Drow is a dark-skinned, white-haired elf. His hair is pulled back into a tight ponytail. They are basically the evil counterpart of elves. And he's got a bow and arrow, and he's searching around.
The first thought is, how come we didn't see them when we first came in? We must have gotten really, really, really lucky not to run into them immediately.
Still holding the glass, I'm going to say barracks.
Barracks. You see, like, a bunch of basically the guards, like, kind of sleeping or sitting around playing cards. It's probably about eight of them or so in, like, a long sort of room.
Okay, what other rooms are in the manor?
Pantry.
You do see the pantry, and there is another person in there patrolling. He's kind of snooping around where you guys were messing around. It is a sort of a surly, gruff-looking, heavy-bearded, wearing armor, holding a cudgel.
How about ballroom? You could have a ballroom, right?
Nothing comes up.
Nothing.
Potions lab.
Basement.
Hold on, what are the diamonds? Like flipping channels.
Potions lab.
Okay, potions lab.
No potions lab.
Is there a basement?
Basement.
No basement.
No basement.
Dungeon.
There is a dungeon.
Oh, found a dungeon.
There is it looks like a crummy pit with shackles and the remains of prisoners. Some may be alive, you can't really tell. And then there are destitute, disgusting conditions. You feel like you could get a disease walking down there.
Wow.
Mm.
Okay.
Well, I'm immune to disease, so.
Yeah. Well, you walk down there, then.
Yeah. If those people are alive and if they want to.
Divine health.
Okay, how about hallway?
All right, hallway, you see another person walking around. This one is gal is covered in like animal armor, leathers. She's got like a necklace of like all these different claws, different sizes and shapes.
Cool.
Yeah,
is she an owl claw hunter?
What's that?
Is she an owl?
No, she's human. Oh,
the owl bear hunter.
Owl bear hunter.
Big crazy red hair.
I like her style.
Where do you shop? The woods. Me too. Yes.
She had on an outfit that, you know, was killing Claire. It was fabulous.
Library.
There
That's
you go.
Yay. Magic books too, probably.
You see, a giant room full of books and even more artwork, all sort of sharing the style of this LaFont guy. And there is a patrolling person there who is a human, gruff, black, shaggy hair. He's wearing some light armor, the chest of which is adorned with a red, sort of a scratchy-looking dragon drawing, and he's got a red armband on.
I recognize this person.
Do tell.
The people that came in to attack my family and kill my father and abduct my sister, they all had red bands on their...
Really?
On top of their... And they had a dragon insignia.
So you're saying this is one of the guys that attacked your family?
Yeah.
Okay, then.
I have to go. Okay, I have to go to
okay,
there.
Hold on. I'm with you, but just...
It's one of those dudes that, you know, tore my family apart and kidnapped my sister. I have to go. I have to get to this guy right now.
Okay, so we need to get past the patrol in the hallway if we're going to get to the library. We're not sure where the library is. Since it's a big room, I'm guessing it's the one that's, like, here. The only way to find out is to check.
Can we see how large the room is through the...
The library looked really big.
Okay, I'm an idiot. Braxton, where's the library?
Oh, right.
It's actually in this next room.
Mm-hmm. Is there a door going in?
Through the hallway.
Okay, yeah, of course. So we've got to go through the hallway.
Is there somebody, can we tell if there's somebody in the hallway right there? Hallway outside of library.
Hallway.
You do not see anyone there right now.
But they're patrolling, so they'll be there shortly. So if I'm watching... You've got the other sending stone.
Yeah.
I can keep an eye on the hallway. You can go out, and when I see that it's clear, I'll be like, go.
Okay.
I'm not sure I want to be with Lasarker by myself. Just saying.
Okay.
Does anybody want to stay with me? But I think
well,
that you should.
Well, I bet...
Malkos doesn't mind staying.
Malkos wants to stay with the painting.
Oh, yeah,
so
Malkos
wants to stay with the painting. He's not going anywhere.
So Malkos and I will stay here for now. You guys, Brack the Stone and everybody else, go out to that doorway... Get your sending stone ready. Whenever I see it's clear, I'll tell you to go. You guys head to the library.
Let me go in first by myself.
Well, do you want to send Brathka in first so he doesn't shoot you on sight?
I like the way you think with this.
Well, I mean, I was thinking my stealth is pretty high. I was hoping to just sneak up on him.
Brathka doesn't need stealth. If Brathka goes in the library, if you go in the library, Brathka, that's not going to attract any attention.
Though. No.
Okay, so why don't we send Brachta in first so we have somebody
you
there.
You can sneak in.
And then you can sneak in and then we'll have the drop on him.
Okay, if you don't mind going to the other side of the room and distracting him so I can get behind him.
We'll do it, whatever you want. However
you
want to
do it. Advantage if like he was distracting him or something?
Possibly.
Okay, so I think we have a plan. Okay. You wait out the door with your sending stone thing. Okay. Brachta goes in.
So he walks in and just kind of...
Shovels some books.
Walks over
shovel,
there.
Shovel.
So, yeah, the guy kind of takes a look at him. Doesn't see anything particularly strange about it.
So he's looking over here?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to dart into the room.
Okay.
So I'm trying to be... I'm being stealthy.
Okay.
And I have my short sword out. And I slowly glide it underneath his neck.
Okay, stealth roll.
Go.
15.
That's good enough. All right, so you have your blade to this guy's throat. Hello?
Hello.
I turn him around, and I was like, and I say, you remember my face?
He's like, yeah.
Get on your knees.
He does so.
I mean, they're going, oh my
god. Are you guys coming in? Or?
I'm watching this. Y'all leave me alone. I'm watching TV. I have my stories. Of course, I was in the other room and I couldn't hear anything. I was just watching like her, like. That's all I got to see, really, but it was cool.
I'll join you if you want, if the hallway's clear to get to there.
Okay. Oh, hold on, hallway, is it clear?
Hallway's clear.
Okay, right, go.
And I'll just...
Library.
And I'll actually be watching the door, kind of, to make sure no one surprises.
All right.
Okay.
I'm loving this.
Tell me what I need to know.
The girl, she was here.
Is she alive?
She's alive.
When did you last see her?
A couple weeks ago. They were leaving for Indale.
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 Is that my sending zone saying that?
You don't hear anything.
I don't hear anything. I can just
you
see
just
it.
See stuff.
Crap, okay.
What did they plan to do with her?
Keep her. That's what we do. We conquer. We take. Keep.
I'm like, I want to destroy him. I want to kill him.
Claire, sorry, Will. Claire, pick up.
Your little rock is like glowing red. Yeah.
Claire, pick up.
What do you want?
What's going on?
I'm about to kill this guy.
Whoa. What's going on? We came there for info. What's the info?
They took her to Indale.
I'm sorry, you said Indale.
Yeah. Do you know where that is?
Alcos, take over.
Okay.
I am coming out here. Peek.
Really, Malkos has been staring at the painting the whole time.
I'll take over.
you got that right there?
Distracted.
Claire, do me a favor. Don't kill just quite yet. Just hold that pose.
I'm like taking my sword and just kind of like poking it into his neck.
That's cool. Keep poking.
Blood trickle down.
I've got a question for you. You said Indale.
Yes.
Why were they taking her to Indale?
Well, that's where we're making our base.
Your base is in Indale.
Well, we have allies there, so.
Where is this place?
That's my home.
Oh. How lucky for you.
Lucky?
Yeah. It's a nice place.
Who was your ally there?
Oh, I don't know their name. There's someone high up.
What do you want to bet? It's your brother.
I grab his hand, I put it on the ground, and I chop it off.
What?
Pause for a second. I
just chopped off a guy's hand. This is the worst timing ever.
You can do it with even more flair.
Okay.
They're taking your sister to my home.
How far away is it?
It's quite a ways. It's not close.
He said that they left 2 weeks ago.
They might be there by now. It's a few weeks to get there.
We have to go. I have to go.
I'll come with you.
Let me explain something about my home. This is not just a house. This is a nation within itself. This is a well-defended, very powerful place. It's not some place we can just walk in. And apparently, it's not some place where I am welcome anymore. If we go there, there will be a significant amount of problems.
I have no choice.
I understand, but let's have a plan.
Okay.
Okay. I'm with you because...
Is she still watching to make sure no one's sneaking up on us while this is happening? Got it.
If my brother's involved with this, that's a problem.
So it's interesting because it seems like our backstories might soon kind of overlap in an interesting way because that's where his family is located. So I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Do we need this guy? Because I'm ready to fillet him.
You know what? I don't know. I'm not sure. I mean, what does this guy have to offer? He's not with the group. He's left here.
Do you have anything to say?
I do what I do. Why I do it. I don't have anything to defend myself for.
So you have no regrets.
She's just a child.
And she'll be perfect for bringing back our Lord.
I shove the short sword through his throat.
It's all bloody and awful and gross.
And I stare into his eyes as I watch him die.
Ooh. Brutal.
I watched my father die. So I wanted to watch one of the people that was responsible for that. I wanted to watch him die as well.
I want to search the body, see if there's anything that will help. Any information or anything we can find.
Oh, you find 30 gold.
Okay. That helps.
Yep. Did you leave me with the sending stone before you left the room?
Nope.
Okay. Nope.
Cool.
Just checking. That's unfortunate, isn't it?
He had a very nice dagger.
Oh, okay. I'm going to take the dagger. Really nice dagger. Come over here. Claire, you going to be okay?
What are they doing with her?
We're going to find out. Okay, Claire.
We'll find her. We'll save her.
Look at me real quick. This is a dagger that they used. Take it. Because you're going to use this to drive it through their face.
We have to find her.
We will.
We have to go.
We will.
We're going to figure this out. You gotta trust me that this is gonna be pretty dangerous, so we need a plan, we need to get prepared. There's a lot of stuff we're gonna have to figure out here.
I think they're gonna sacrifice her.
We'll hurry. We need to figure out a way to get out of here. Do we care about Lasarka anymore?
Not terribly.
I don't.
But I want to check if we can free the prisoners that we saw in his dungeon.
Brack, where's the dungeon?
Oh, it's you're going to go outside and there's an entrance to that out there.
I say first we go back to the mirror room, give whoever is watching there the sending stone so that we can have like a home base who can say.
Okay, let's go back to the room.
And then I want to free the prisoners and we can go after.
We at least need to go back to the room because we've got to pick up our friends here.
I go back to his body and I take off his clothes.
Okay, you keeping them?
I'm keeping them.
Die.
Good idea. So, peek. Anything in the hallway? Nothing in the hallway?
No.
Wait, Brakka. Would you be able to leave without the Sarkar being dead? Would you be able to leave and... Or does he have to die before you'll be free?
Well, he will track me down and kill me. That will happen.
That gives us a reason to stay and figure out how to kill Lasarka.
I mean, what do you want to do? Do you want to stay here? Or do you want to come with us?
No, if I stay here, I'm dead.
And if you come with us, you're dead?
You're dead later.
Well, if you come with us, there's at least the chance that, you know, we may be able to figure out a way to help. And we may be able to find a way to defeat and defend ourselves against this guy. There's a better chance if you come with us than if you stay here. I think, Brakta, if you want to join us... Join us.
All right, I'm going to pause that. You. So Stonehand's got an eye on Lasarka. Malkos is staring at the painting. It's closer and closer and closer to it. Kind of checking it out, looking at the frame.
Don't touch it.
And you hear Lasarka finally make himself known. Stonehand looks at him and looks at you.
Well, he's either telling you not to touch it or he's casting some sort of spell since you're in its proximity.
He does seem to be pretty upset as Malkos gets closer and closer to that painting.
Can he hear me or is Malkos like totally entranced?
Malkos can hear you talk,
okay.
Yeah.
He not care.
He like is really into the painting though.
It's like Ghostbusters too.
That painting of Vigo.
Yes. Yeah.
I guess I'm going to take my hand off our eye for a second and pull him back.
Malkos.
Pull Malkos back.
All right. It doesn't take a strength. test. He's weak.
Sit back, little man.
What? What?
Let's just wait a second before we, you know, go putting hands all over this painting.
It's why we're here.
Yes, it is. Come on. But everyone else is going to be back shortly. And then we'll make a plan to get this thing out of here.
All right. I ain't got too much more patience, though. I'm ready to get this thing out of here. I'm afraid of these guys.
No, we'll do it quickly. They're on their way back.
This is supposed to be a smash and grab. We've just smashed and smashed and smashed and gotten right smashed. Back to y'all.
Okay. So we're going back to the room.
Yes.
Yes.
Is it clear?
Peek.
Yes.
Okay. Who's the stealthiest of us right now?
I am.
Maybe you should like go and check some corners and stuff like that.
Okay. I run out and I check this corner.
Nothing on that side.
Are you making an effort to be stealthy? Like, because you said
yes.
You were...
All right. I'm being stealthy about this. I checked this corner real quick.
You actually see someone is about to...
Make the turn?
Yep.
Okay, I run back in here. I'm like, somebody is about to make the turn over here.
We need to get the drop on her, or we wait for her to pass?
I think we should... I don't know. Maybe wait a second and see if she just, like, walks all the way around.
Okay, so...
So go back and... Side the room.
Yeah, we're in the room. I'm gonna put my ear to the door, see if I can hear footsteps out there.
You hear her walk by.
All the way.
Actually, you don't hear her walk by. She's really good at walking quietly. She's a nature person.
Damn. Making so am I. Okay. Is there a gap underneath the door?
Sure.
I lay down on the floor and look underneath the gap.
All right, you do actually see her pass by.
Okay, all the way over here?
Well, you see her walk by.
Let's give it a few minutes.
You can kind of figure out like about how long it'll take her at the pace she's walking by to round out the other side.
Okay.
Let's do that. Okay. I'm going to stealthy style look out again. Do I see anything?
Nope.
Okay. I'm going to look around this corner stealthy style.
Do you see her walking down towards the end of the other side?
Okay. I'm going to wait until she makes the corner.
Alrighty.
Alright, let's go.
I really love the way this has devolved into us like, okay, let's do this. Okay, I'll go over here. Okay, let's do
G.I. Joe's.
Oh, I'm worried about the prisoner plan.
I don't know that we have time for that.
Is there a window in this room?
No.
Is there a window in this room?
Let's change the question. Braksha, yeah. Is there another way out other than the front door?
That's the one.
I asked Braksha if he saw the girl.
I did not see.
You never saw her?
He was recently brought on, actually. He was part of a traveling group, but Lazarker hired him to hunt him a dragon. To capture one. He hadn't done it yet. That's why there's not one in the game room. Mm. But that was his big hunt.
So we were told earlier that we could see everywhere because of the beholder, and these animals were enchanted some way. What does the owlbear do? Anything? Is it just in place, or
the owlbear has the ability to deafen any room.
Deafen.
Yeah, deafening screech.
Okay.
Fills the room until you call it off.
Okay. And how about the bugbear? Not the bugbear. The bug.
This. Know.
The bugbear allows him to actually pass into any room.
Oh, so Lazarker can go anywhere he wants.
Yeah. Hmm. It's a good thing you bound him up.
I'm glad we did that.
Jeez. Okay. All he had to do was say a word and he would have been gone.
Okay. Is that power purely the Sarkers, or can we use it like we're using the seeing?
I've never seen anyone else use it.
Hmm. Because that sure would make life easier if we could just say, like, outside. One thing I did not do, which was unfortunate, is I did not look through the library.
You want to go back?
Yeah.
Want is a strong word. But I will go back. Let's check the thing. Hallway. Let's do the thing. I'm going to give my sending stone. Claire, can you hang out here for a minute?
Yeah.
Claire, hang out with your sending stone.
I'll go with you to the library.
Okay, so we're going to the library. Who are you? As an elf who studied a lot of history in my past, I'm always trying to gain knowledge. I also think there's probably something, maybe something, in this manner that will give us some clues to how we can actually stop Lasarker. I'm not seeing it, but I thought we should at least look. Claire, are we clear?
Yeah.
Yes.
We're looking in the...
Okay, so we're in the library.
And you're sending stuff.
I want to search the library.
What are you searching for?
Checking out the books. I want to see if there's anything that might give us some clue as to Lasarker's source of power. I mean, this is a magic user guy, so I'm looking for magical books. I'm looking for anything like that that can help us out.
You don't really see any magical books. Mostly what he has is kind of like rare first editions and exotic, you know, illustrated books.
More of the whole, like, rare, sinister, sloppy kind of stuff.
Vanity, I have this super cool first edition.
So this isn't a library for knowledge. This is a library for show.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm not seeing anything fancy in this library.
Nothing that's really telling you more about his power.
Okay. The paintings, anything special about the paintings that are there?
Art books.
What's that, art books?
Yeah, any art books.
Lots of art books. The paintings are kind of more like human life, town life kind of stuff from LaFont.
So this guy loves his artist.
Yeah.
Is there any book that will tell me some more of the history of LaFont?
Oh, you gonna look around for a book about him?
Yeah.
There you go. You found one.
Hey, I found a book about LaFont.
Hey.
I'd like to kind of go through there, and let's flip to the end.
You're going to go to the end?
Yeah.
Oh, I hate it when people read the end of the book.
But we know it's his last painting, so.
All right.
Yeah.
So you flip through the whole book, kind of scanning through, and you're seeing like a lot of the paintings that are in this guy's place. Mm-hmm. As you get towards the end, you don't see a picture of the Blameless Maiden. You see a mention of it. It was his final painting. After that, he mysteriously died. No one knows how, when, or why. But that painting had never been seen by the public. Except there's no, like, I mean, he actually could be alive for what they know.
I was going to say, died or disappeared.
But, yeah, disappeared is a better thing. But he stopped painting completely after this Blameless Maiden thing.
Was it a commissioned piece?
It was a commissioned piece.
By?
That does not say.
Does anyone else here think that maybe the Sarker cares about the Blameless Maiden not just because it's like such a great, beautiful painting? Do you think it has something to do with like his powers somehow? Like he seems to really... I bet he commissioned the painting, and there was some, and there's some magic about it that's connected to why we can't.
It's reasonable, I think. I mean, I think he either commissioned the painting or he is LaFont.
That's what I was thinking.
Whoa! I didn't.
Whoa!
There's no picture of LaFont anywhere in all this stuff, though.
So. There is.
There is.
And it's not. It does not look like Lasarker. Unless, I mean, Lasarker is really old,
yeah.
So he could look like a.
But like
he doesn't share
I could not extrapolate an older LaFont.
You would not see that out of him. Yeah.
All right, so not LaFont, although I like that kind of idea.
It was a good theory.
I think what if he got LaFont to, like, he commissioned this piece. He got, there's some magic about it that has to do with his power. That's why he got so nervous when they were getting near the painting and stuff. And then he made sure LaFont disappeared after that so that no one would ever find out the secret about the Blameless Maiden.
That's
painting.
Reasonable, so what do we do with that?
I think we should touch the painting.
Investigate the painting.
Are you guys deciding this in our room? Malchus says, I got it. I appreciate art.
Just so we know, the last time you got near it, he started
mumbling
something.
But he's gagged. I like check his gag to make sure that it's still
tight.
I
can't do wordless magic.
All right, so Malchus very delicately touches, and the Sarker's like,
"Woof!" I just not want him.
This makes him grumpy.
His woman,
yeah.
Oh man, what if we have to destroy the painting to kill the Sarker?
I mean, so is it like tickling him?
He's just agitated.
Angry or touching?
What would happen if like there was a little? If, like, something small happened to the painting, would it affect...
Malcolm says, we're not letting that happen.
Uh-uh. I mean, do you plan to keep it in this frame, or are you going to cut it out of the frame?
If I can keep it in the frame, I'll do that, but I'll probably have to roll it up.
Yeah, I think we have to cut it out anyway, so that requires have to cut it.
Does anyone want to make a little cut in the side near the frame where we cut it out?
I think
anyway,
you just have to score it right by the frame.
Let me do it. So him and Stone Ann pull the framed painting down, and Lazarker's going berserk. He cannot deal with this. He's wriggling,
Is anyone watching the Sarker and making sure he's
right beside us?
We're all there.
Eyes on.
You and me are over there.
Oh, we're still not there. Okay, forgot.
Fighting against his restraints, but not succeeding. And Malco slowly, carefully, feels really bad about doing it, cuts the painting loose from its frame.
Okay.
Rolls it up.
Without any...
What does the Sarker do?
Is he?
He's going berserk. He's like flipping.
He's not bleeding from his eyeballs?
He's not.
Okay. There's nothing written on the back of the painting?
No. It's just a beautiful painting.
I don't know whether it's just, you know, this woman that he is obsessed with, and she is the end all be all of his world. The romantic of me would like to think that is true. I don't know. But something tells me there's some other magical quality or connection between those two, but I don't know what that is. Let's get out of here.
I think we're
let's figure out our exit.
If he's going so,
there's a knock at the wall.
Of course there is.
The wall Which behind wall? The painting.
The secret door.
Oh, the secret door leading into the room.
Yeah.
Oh, so somebody wants in.
I'm like, is that you guys?
You guys have the eye thingy.
Okay. I'm like, bedroom, or whatever that room is.
It's the drow elf.
Just when one of you, like, tries to sound like a Sarker.
Wait.
Hello.
This is, what's his face,
Recta.
Right? Okay, I'm like, dude, respond.
What do you want?
What do I say? I'm not supposed to be in here.
Oh, you're not?
I can be in here, but I'm not, it's my thing. They're going to want to hear from him.
What do we do?
Oh,
let him in.
On the sending stone.
Oh, please, you're table talking.
No.
We have a sending stone
outside our door.
Oh, they can sneak up on him and try and like. Oh, yeah. Wait, but no one does
right.
That's
what I was thinking.
Wait, your spells.
I'm not going to say anything. You guys might want to take care of it.
10-4. Sorry.
You hate these sending stones so much.
Worst thing I ever gave you.
It just lets us split up. Okay, so...
they crack after their 1,000th use.
We got a little worse.
We're on 4.
Peeking out in the hallway, the drow who's been patrolling the hallway...
The female ranger type was
the ranger. Yes, the drow's over there now. So the female ranger peeking out... See anything?
You do not see her.
Hear anything?
You do not hear anything.
Be quick like a bunny.
Okay, I'm gonna peek around the corner.
You do not see anything, which is alarming because you probably should have seen her one of those two areas. She's probably gonna be coming up pretty fast on the other side.
I'm gonna run in and I'm gonna catch the drow off guard.
Alrighty.
I'm going, yeah.
You're coming with
I'm
me?
I'm going with you.
Boom.
You're running up, surprising him, and going, surprise!
No, you can
happy
just,
birthday!
Like,
freeze.
Like, you have a sword, right? Like, you could just put that sword straight through her. Or him. Him? Drow?
Him.
Him.
Immediate death?
Yeah.
Permanent death.
All right.
Attack! Your attack?
Cell style.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you will get advantage on your attack. So you get to roll 2 d20s and take the higher number.
12.
Yay, 12. 12 plus 2. Okay. Oh, you only have a mace. She doesn't have a sword. She has a mace.
I bludgeoned.
Knocking unconscious, baby. So 12 plus 2.
Hits.
Two.
Which is probably not enough.
No.
Well, maybe it's...
He did not kill him.
Get her on the ground for a minute?
It's a hit.
Second?
Oh, no.
No.
You just really just went, hey! just ran in the room like, hi.
So, initiative for the drow and you two.
5 plus 2, 7.
7.
Jeez.
-1, 6.
Damn, homie.
I have a -1 for my initiative. So yeah, Kira's not one to run first.
Tyra's your character's name? Kira.
Kira Knightley.
That's, well, I started thinking like Tyra Banks.
Knightley does sound like a D&D character.
It really does, doesn't it? Is that your last name?
No.
It should be.
It is now.
Kira Knightley.
You're messing with my immersion.
Could be. All right, anyway.
So she will now be known as Kira Knightley, or has always been known as Kira Knightley, obviously. Sounds the same, but spelled completely differently. So we're fine. That's how that works.
So Tarwill goes first.
So unfortunately, I'm like right next to this person.
You're good. I think he's a magic user too, so just have better magic.
Throwing a witch bolt. 18 plus 6, 24.
Hits.
Nice. Bam! And that is 1d12, I believe.
Yep, yep.
7.
All right. Alrighty, now it is Kira's turn.
Oh, Kira.
You're witch bolting.
I'm witch bolting. I'm holding in that lightning.
I am going to inflict wounds.
Brutal.
What is that?
What
does it do?
I think it does what it says.
Have a like magic swords go flying through the air.
Hey, that's a great idea.
Like,
how do you want it to be?
Oh, yeah, there you go. There you go.
I never use it on.
And then he gashes open. No, it's just like a bolt, really a bolt, a guided bolt of energy. And then I just tend to slash over vital organs.
19. Plus 5.
Boom.
Bam.
Yep, yep.
Get it.
3d10 necrotic damage.
Jeez Louise.
Oh my god, you guys are...
That's 10.
He'll be dead. He'll be dead.
Let's go.
4.
7. 9.
He screams and falls to the ground.
Yes!
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do.
High 5. Bam!
Done.
Leave me. Hey,
can't reach.
So he's down, right?
Yeah.
Okay, first thing I want to do is I want to search the body, see if there's anything I need.
Oh, he's got a short sword, and he's got a longbow.
Nothing special.
I need a bow.
I need some arrows.
Can you use a bow? You can use
we'll
a bow.
We'll say too. He's got 20 gold.
Does he have very a good. Very nice something?
I have so much gold right now.
Yeah, so you have a ranged tells. Weapon.
Okay, so grab his longbow then. Or short bow, whatever it was.
It was a longbow.
Longbow. Okay, so grab the longbow. Okay, so drow's down. I'm going to go over to the secret door. I want to open up the secret door, and he's like, we got it, guys. Just be like, we're good.
Okay. Let's get out of here.
All right, are we leaving the Sarker?
I mean, do we want to try and kill him?
I don't know how.
I think...
I don't either.
Can we just do like a few perceptions on like this or like Arcana or something?
What
on
are we perceiving?
Like I hate leaving because I'm pretty sure it has to do with the Blameless Maiden painting. Except for I don't know what in it. I don't know. Just like if you notice anything strange about it. Like a little background picture in it. I don't know.
He could just be a lovesick dude and that's his lady lover.
I doubt it.
Evil people can
Maybe.
Love. I don't know what else to do. We've done Arcana checks on it.
Yeah.
We've done perception checks on it.
He freaked out when we cut it out of the frame and rolled it up, but nothing happened to him.
I think it's just his prized possession, and he doesn't want to give it up.
You're going to have to commit.
If you separate
if it's the painting, you're going to have to destroy the painting.
Try getting that
fast. Maybe it's taking the painting somewhere. Like maybe just taking the painting out of the building will do something.
Only one way to find out.
Except for then, we won't be able to get Alcos to come back. If it doesn't work, so.
What if we take him outside and bury him?
there are still guards patrolling, though. I mean, we've gotten rid of the drow. There's still the girl that's patrolling the hallway, and there's the big guy that was hanging out in the pantry, which I'm assuming, unless he's just gorging himself on jerky, he's not in the pantry anymore.
Probably not.
I think we need to just go. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Are we leaving Lasarka, or are we bringing him with us?
I'm fine leaving him.
I'm going to ask Braktha if he ever leaves the fortress.
Oh, yeah. He leaves for his for his swaps and to collect items. All right. And he leaves.
There's no problem with leaving. Yeah.
He's.
And he doesn't have a problem with getting too far from the painting, right? Like, he never acts oddly when he comes back from the swap. Like, he.
Well, he definitely. The first thing he does when he returns is goes to that room and stares at it for a few days.
let's leave the Sarker here.
I think if we take the paint, if any of his power is held in the painting, then that'll be far away from him, so he'll at least be weakened if we leave him.
Let's leave the Sarker.
That's a good theory.
Let's go. All right. Gonna die. Here we go. We're all gonna die. I can't hear you.
We're all gonna die.
Oh my god, there are so many figures here. Here.
Yeah.
A giant fist comes out of the sky and stampedes everyone.
Hey! What are you doing?
Oh, we've been discovered?
Yeah, no one checked.
We just grabbed all the pieces and just like went out into the hallway before we checked. And then there's somebody waiting. But we haven't really fought anybody today, so that's good. We should be fighting. We don't have to, but we're playing D&D. That's what you do. Fight the bad guys.
Whatever. Okay.
Where is that coming from?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of us. 7 of us.
Is there an intimidation? Who has intimidation?
Not me.
Don't you have it?
Charisma.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you have intimidation.
Great. Not that good at that.
What do you mean?
Well, no, my character's fine, and I, as Abby, don't know what to say. What do I say?
I want some shade.
Yeah, be like, what's up? You really want to mess with us?
I mean, you gotta
turn around.
Be like, shoot or die. Okay. What do you want to do? Or who is it? Which one is it?
Yeah, who are we looking at?
The lady or the?
The female hunter.
Female hunter with the crossbow.
And an axe.
And an axe. Crossbow and an axe. Where's she at?
She's down at the end of the hall. There you go.
Cool.
I mean, if we're all at the ready, and then you're like...
Yeah.
I mean, my first reaction is, really?
I know, right?
All right, how about we're leaving? Do you want to stand in our way?
You're the one saying it. You're trying to intimidate?
Yep.
Intimidation.
Intimidation, which is +4, because +2, +2.
13.
13, right. Intimidation.
She's not that impressed. Okay. She opens the door behind her. The barracks.
Oh, they're the barracks. Mm-hmm.
And out come 8 soldiers.
Great. Yes, she does want to stare.
Okay, I need to put him to sleep. And they are within range.
They're all clustered right there.
So I've got my 5d8 for the hit points. 3, 4, 9, 10, 18. So 18 hit points worth of characters.
One guard falls asleep.
Okay, fine.
That was a waste.
Initiative.
All right.
What did you get?
3 - 1.
Oh my god, yeah.
3 - 1.
I'm just gonna sit here in the back.
Don't mind me.
Tarwheel.
7.
Good lord.
21.
There you go.
Bam, there we go.
I cast Horde Breaker. So I'm aiming for her.
All right.
And I'm going to attack with my longbow. 12 + 7. 19.
Oh, that's a hit.
So 7 + 5, 12 points of damage. Can I attack her again?
No, it has to be someone else.
Okay.
That's the whole horde thing.
Damn. A horde of one.
So I attack the guard closest to her.
Okay.
Ooh, 7 + 2.
Not going to get it done.
Okay. All right, it was a try.
And now it is the hunter's turn. She holds up her crossbow to you.
To who?
To me.
To Amanda, the one who just got a hit on her.
Yeah. That's a good hit.
She misses.
Ooh, nice.
I laugh.
Let's do a perception roll.
I do, okay.
Oh my.
14 + 5, 19.
Okay, you look at her arrow that hits the wall, tipped with poison.
Oh my god.
These are poison arrows, guys.
Awesome.
I take it off the wall.
Okay.
I'm really resisting seeing an old ABC.
Hey, are you allowed to shoot her own poison back at her by
that's
like transferring
my plan.
It
to... poison
into my heart. Oh.
What?
Whoops. Well, one of the guards falls.
Oh no.
On his own sword?
Almost. Oh my god, I cannot roll above a 5. Yes. What's your armor class, Taruel?
13.
Okay, one of them runs up and hits you for 7 slashing damage.
Oh. That's why I should have rested on my lay on hands. It can heal.
What's your armor class?
Huh?
What do you, yeah.
18.
Okay, miss. All the 6 of the guards, the one that didn't fall asleep and the one that fell down, they all come running up and sort of like fill up the hallway in front of you guys. But they are apparently inept and can't
yay.
Do anything.
Okay.
Now it is Tarwheel's turn.
Outstanding. I feel like this needs to be like a Burning Hands thing. It's only a 15-foot cone, though, so it's only getting these guys that are right in front of us. Burning Hands, everybody has to make a dexterity saving throw against 14.
Is that in a cone, or?
It's a cone.
Oh, good. Against 14?
Against 14.
All right, let me ask you this. Should they all roll as a team, or should they each roll individually? Oh, that's me messing with Mark. I'm giving you the choice. That way, if it fails on your part, you have no one to blame but yourself.
I almost think that we should go individually, because, I mean, he gets one good roll and the spell's wasted.
Yeah.
I think individually.
Okay, so what do they have to roll over?
14 with dexterity.
Can we see?
Can you tell us what your first one
is? Yeah, I'll tell you what my first one is.
You need to use some allergy meds, sir.
I took Claritin this morning.
Yeah, it's the worst. Sponsored by Claritin. The worst.
The worst. First one was an 18, so.
Okay, so that's one is?
4 is a miss.
Okay, so it's 1.
3 is a miss. Okay. He chose right. 14 is safe. 1 is definitely a miss. And they will probably incinerate. 6 is a miss. So
4 of those?
You hit 4, 2 are resistant.
3d6. 11, and then the 2 that saved have half that.
All right. So the 4 scream in fiery blazes. The 2 take big hits.
Nice.
And are scorched.
That's a good hit.
Yeah.
I like that.
I'm going to, can I make it to her if I run up, or how far are you here?
1, 10, 2, 20, nope, you can't make it.
Lame.
You can hit, lame, you can hit one of those 2 guys that are remaining.
Well, actually, isn't there something where I can like run and get up to her, just not do anything else, just stand there, because if she's ranged, then she can't hit me with her arrows, and I might like... Isn't it disadvantage if I'm next to her and she's doing range?
If she tries to do range.
Oh, yeah.
She also has an axe.
Oh, well, yeah. But if she does the ranged poison arrow.
Yeah, you can sprint up to her.
I'm going to run up to her.
Now it is Kira's turn.
Well, now that you've put yourself right in the middle of
that. I don't have to be.
We still have 2 other soldiers that are half dead.
I'm going to throw some sacred flame.
Sacred flame.
Sacred flame.
They're rolling. They have to succeed dexterity 13.
Do you have to pray to something to do this?
To the agnostic cleric?
Yeah.
Like, whatever.
Maybe you're there, maybe you're not. I'm not sure.
Sacred flame! They have to get over 13?
Yes.
They both do. So do they take some
damage?
Well,
it was only on 1. It was 1.
Yeah, it was just 1.
Oh, okay. Claire.
I'm gonna attack the one closest to Cyndia.
Okay.
With my longbow. 18 plus 7. Okay. So that's 8 points.
Okay, he dies.
Boom. Yeah.
You're dead.
Thunk. Ugh. Take an arrow into the temple. continues falling.
What about, is Stonan not?
I forgot their turn.
No. Okay.
I was just thinking that too. I was like,
I'm like, he's really strong. Yeah. He could probably just.
They're actually
like,
just watching us.
Through
like,
those.
And
like,
isn't.
They're doing okay.
Like, Eva. Yeah.
Right. Stonan flies into a rage.
Yay.
And he runs up to the other guard, takes his massive sword, Stonan Slayer, and slashes the guy into a spray of blood and mist all over the wall.
He like cuts him in half and one half just like slides off of him.
And no more guards. Well, I guess there's the one that's actually asleep over there.
Oh yeah, technically. Yeah. And he's only asleep for a minute.
So all the guards are done?
Well, there's the sleeping one and then there's the one who's gonna recuperate this turn over by the door. And then the huntress. Now it is her turn, the huntress's turn, actually.
Right.
What's your armor class again, 18?
Yeah, you're a tank.
You are a tank. Oh my goodness. So she she grabs her axe, seeing that you're a melee threat, and strikes at you, and the axe gets stuck in your sword.
Cool. Wait, my sword?
it's out of her hand.
Yeah. Oh.
You basically pull one of those moves where you catch it on the blade and pull it away from her.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's awesome.
So you were defensively a badass. And she was actually very poor.
And she's like,
oh,
crap. Oh, bummer.
Let's see. The soldier who fell on himself takes a swipe at Sendia, but does nothing. Tarwheel.
Let's see what I want to do right now. How about... so there's no soldiers over here.
Correct.
I think I probably want to throw... Let me come over here so I have a clear shot.
A clear shot.
Clear shot. and I'm going to throw a firebolt.
Firebolt.
It's ranged spell attack. 11 plus 6, 17.
That is big enough.
Cool. 1d10 fire damage. We'll just roll this one. 4.
She takes a blast. She really doesn't seem all that phased yet. She's battle-hardened.
All right.
Your turn.
Great, my turn.
You're up on her.
I am up on her. I will raise my sword, cry a prayer to Heronius to help me protect my friends, and then I will bring it down and attack her.
All right.
And I will roll for that.
It's a 14.
You hit.
It's a 20.
20.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yay.
Damage.
So that damage will be 1d8 plus 6 of slashing damage.
You know, this is how people actually learn to play the game, is watching her play.
Yeah. 3 plus 6.
All right. She takes the sword hit, but she knows how to deflect so she doesn't get hit in any vital areas. Which is my way of explaining how you can take a sword hit and live through it. Kira.
You're way better. And you only have a speed of 30 feet.
So I have to throw a spell, basically.
Oh, you're blocked.
Yeah.
Or you could check around the corner to make sure we're not going to get snuck up on and flanked.
I guess I'll do that. So I'm going to move...
To here?
I'm going to reach
peek
and stop.
Around.
Yep. You see a guy. He's in front of the door. That's our big cudgel-wielding brute.
All right.
We can't do anything else, right?
You could try something else. Yeah, you've moved. You can attack.
Could you do a spell on him?
I'm going to inflict some wounds.
Yeah. All by yourself.
Watch out for the wounds.
20.
Whoa.
Bam! What?
She rolled a 20.
Bam!
All right. So,
what damage do you do?
I'm looking it up again.
It's like 3d10, right?
3d10. Oh wow!
6d10.
Oh my goodness! 6d10.
Here, let's see if we can do. Can we get 6 tens?
Take my 10. You can have this. You can have my. Here, use this too.
And my sword.
Style 10. Just.
And my axe. There's 6. There's 6 tens that'll die.
Okay.
I don't know, it just seems so cool to have like a whole handful of dice and like rolling big and seeing them all at the same time.
Like, get the power!
Oh god!
Well, I'll re-roll that one.
Nine, played 11, as lies. 13, 16,
yeah, what is it?
16 so far.
21.
All right. So, explain the look of your spell.
Can I have?
Oh, it's.
Can I have my tens back?
We're
slashing. Nope.
Okay.
And he's breaking open, and blood is pouring out everywhere.
You really are doing the symptom septo. Yeah. Yeah,
exactly. I'm just feeling that. Sorry, out. J.K. Rowling.
Grarg, hurt. Grarg.
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 This is the chateau of badly named people. Clearly, I actually came up with it a little bit ahead of time. I just like the name. He looks like a Grarg.
Is Grarg still alive?
He's still alive.
Oh. He's just hurt. Stonehand.
He's gonna run up and attack the not sleeping guard.
This one out here.
Oh, he just he splits him like a freaking walnut. Wipes his blade off on the mess.
This one's done.
That one's done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yay.
And Malkos takes the painting over to where you are.
Is this one?
Over by Melody, yeah. And then halts dead in his tracks when he sees the big, bloody, messy dude. Claire.
All right. We have the lady and this dude.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to move so that I can position myself to hit this lady.
Okay.
So I'm going to attack with my longbow. 18 plus 7. Yeah. 7.
She takes the arrow. Still doing okay, though.
Mm. Okay.
Now it is her turn. What is she gonna do? She's gonna take off.
She's running?
She's gonna try.
Seems smart.
Does that mean I get an
opportunity? Yeah. Yep.
I'm going to pray to Heronius to vanquish her so she can't do any more harm once she
vanquish.
11 plus 6.
Yeah, you hit her.
It hits?
Yep.
Cool. So here's my d8. 7 plus 6.
Nice.
All right, so she is badly hurt. She's bloodied. She's got wounds all over. But she's taking off for, that direction. Tartar wheel.
Should I do that now?
I mean, you would have to go back to the...
I know. I mean, I guess we should clear out these guys before I do that.
I mean, you're right there.
Pretty close. I mean,
you would have to do everything, though.
Well, I need somebody else to swing because I don't have anything that could do that damage.
Okay. I'll have to wait till my turn to follow you.
So you're going
to
come with me?
I think it would be good.
You guys have this. We're going to try something crazy.
Oh. What are you doing?
The Sark is over there, right?
Yeah.
Still tied up?
Yeah.
Okay. And we are in combat now.
You can tell he was wriggling free, though.
He's wriggling free? I am going to cast a Chill Touch cantrip on him.
Okay.
So a ranged spell attack. Critical fail.
Nice.
What do you do? He Chill Touches the...
You shatter the mirrors.
Okay, well, we're done with the mirrors.
Well, that's actually fine. Really care,
yeah.
Yeah, that's all right, really cool. Fine.
What are you trying to do?
Chill touch. On a hit, target takes 1d8 necrotic damage and can't regain hit points until the start of my next turn. See where I'm going with that?
I see where you're going with it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now it is Cindy's turn.
Oh, yay. I guess I will go after her.
Can you catch up to her, though?
Should I go after her, or should I just take out that guard that's on the ground already?
You can only move 30 feet, so you can't actually get to her.
Then I should probably just take out that guard, right?
Yeah.
All
right. So you're going to move here and take out the guard? Pray to Heronius.
Do it.
Oh, okay.
Do what you want to do.
Do it.
It's your game.
All right. Why is I looking at you? Should we take out the cards?
Just take out the cards.
I will raise my sword and bring it
And I guess I will pray to Heronius, and I will bring it down on the guard. I feel so bad because it's just on the ground.
Well, then don't do it.
All right. I guess I don't feel like we should kill the guard. I'm going to ask you guys, should we just leave him? Why is he? He's just a worker.
We're in the middle of battle. Yeah, we can't have a debate really on morality about right stuff. Now. So you've got to decide whether you're going to kill him or not.
I must say, in my defense, I was told that I could be out of combat if I wanted to. So I wasn't everyone else was dead. The fighting was around the corner. I was not technically in battle.
There's a door there.
The entrance to the barracks.
Shove him out and close the door, like lock it.
So you're just pushing him into the barracks?
Yeah. I would push him into the barracks. And if there's any way to block the door, we can come back in super quick.
Probably not really an effective way to block the door, but just close the door.
Close the door. He wakes up. He's like, wait, where'd all my friends go?
That was the worst dream I've ever had.
Why am I here?
Why is everyone dead? So you shove him in the room and close it off.
You know.
Now it is Kira's turn.
So we've got this guy on the ground.
He's not on the ground. He just took a big hit.
Ow. Another spell slot. We only have four.
I'm gonna shoot him with my newly acquired longbow. Finish him off.
Are you proficient in longbow?
She is proficient in longbow.
Oh, okay.
So you just roll an attack plus two. Damage is 1d8.
Okay.
What'd she do?
Critical fail! Should've kept the spell going.
You broke your new longbow.
Oh, well.
Aww. It just like cracks in half.
Dang it.
That was quick. Nice knowing your longbow. Just chuck it over your
shoulder. It was actually a really rare, valuable longbow, too.
I can't even talk about that. It's so sad. Yeah, no, that was a fail. That was a epic. I didn't think it would break. What's that about? I didn't know that happens. I mean, yeah. So yeah, this power has to be yielded correctly, apparently.
It's his turn.
Oh, hey.
He runs Get up laughing at that, even though he's bleeding all over.
He broke the bow.
User. Which armor class?
15.
He misses.
Yay.
He takes a swipe with his cudgel, but he's too busy laughing at that whole bow thing. Yeah, I know. Stony doesn't really know what to do, so he just kind of shrugs.
Okay.
Malkus is hanging back, waiting to see how this goes.
These guys.
It's kind of expensive art.
I guess.
Claire.
Okay. I'm going this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's as far as I can get. That's it.
It's okay. Our huntress is headed out the door.
Bam, 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 bam.
Yep.
Get me out of here.
She's gone.
She's about to be.
Let her go.
Tire wheel.
Okay, I'm going to cast Chill Touch again. It's a cantrip, so I can just keep throwing this thing. 9 plus 6, 15. Okay, so 1d8 damage. 4. Plus, he cannot regain hit points until the start of my next turn.
Send you.
Oh.
So you're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Are you running?
Well, I guess there's not much I can do, but sure, I'll run.
Okay, so another 6 spaces, is that right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Perfect.
So I'm there, but I can't do anything.
Kira.
I'm close enough to mace. 19.
Plus.
Boom.
2. 2. 21.
That's a hit.
8.
Ooh, bam.
Solid hit.
Nice hit.
Now it's his turn. He takes the mace to the chest. He's like, ooh, ah.
Are you related to somebody?
Just me. He takes a swipe back and misses you.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah, my rolls for the hunters were dreadful. I mean, I said at one point, I couldn't roll over 5. I wasn't kidding. 3, 4, 3, 2, 5. It's like, come on. None of these are going to hit? I mean, that poison arrow would have been devastating. So now they just seem like, you know, cupcakes. It's like, oh, well, that was a really easy adventure. Well, it wasn't. I just roll for crap. All right, Malkos holds the painting back and tries to wiggle his fingers. Whoop. Creates a little fizzle, but it doesn't do anything.
Or you could just put the painting down. And...
Yeah, that's not gonna
not
happen.
So much. Claire.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in here and get on the other side of the room so that I can do a ranged attack.
Oh, cut off his head.
Oh, just cut off his head?
Yeah, I mean, in this dude.
Okay.
If you can, you have a short sword.
I'm take my short sword out and I'm going to just cleave off his head.
You don't have to roll for it.
Oh. Yeah.
Didn't work.
Seals right back up.
Dang it.
What? But he couldn't heal from damage.
That's correct.
It was worth a try.
It was a very valid attempt.
I take the poison arrow that I have and shove it into his eyeball.
Ugh.
It
does hurt. Now he has an arrow sticking into his head, but he's still alive.
I mean, there's only one room we haven't been into, and that's over here. Is the answer in there?
Pop is. I mean, not
Pop. Doubt it. That's what Brendan.
It's the same character.
Same character.
I doubt it. Brendan expected that was one of the first rooms we'd go into.
That was
said
he
fantastically thought we'd go.
So he's all still right. Filling up.
You got to give us credit for trying.
Oh, it was awesome attempt. All right. That's really thinking with your head. I like it a lot. In any other situation, that would have been totally perfect.
Except this guy.
Got this one. Tyler will.
My turn already. Well, Claire, I guess that's not going to work.
Nope.
First thing I'm going to do, just to be safe, I'm going to go over to tighten up his bonds.
Yeah.
Make sure he's
all right,
nice and
tight. Cut your head off.
Like
stab
that.
An arrow into your eye belt. Tighten your bonds.
He's still alive and getting loose. So so that was 15 feet, and now I'll go back to where I was.
Send you.
Okay. Now, is there any way I could move to the flanking there, or is the positioning?
Yeah, you get advantage.
You're not flanking him, but you could. You're.
Get advantage.
You don't get advantage.
There's no way I could move to get advantage. Okay, no. So just I was just wondering since moving. Huh. I will raise my sword and cry a prayer to Heronius, and then I will do this thing again. Now I'm rolling. All right, 15 plus 6.
Oh, that's a hit.
All right. 6 plus 6.
Alrighty. Mm-mm-mm. He's taking some hits, but he's a sturdy dude.
No kidding.
Kira.
Sacred flame.
Sacred flame.
Sacred flame.
Sacred flame. It's different every time.
Must succeed at dexterity saving throw. Against 13.
13.
Fails.
So that is 1d8 radiant damage.
Blood streaming down his face. Still a little singed from the radiant damage. And he is flying into a rage.
Uh-oh.
Right.
It's already is. Jeez.
What's that?
I thought he just went.
Ooh. Sorry.
Did you just die again?
Is it always flying into a rage? Could it just be like
stepping into a rage?
I somersault into a rage.
Stonian always flies into a rage.
I leap into a rage.
Said just like that. I fly into a rage. He does 5 points of damage with a swift cudgel hit.
Well, finally hit her.
He did finally hit.
Yeah.
Stonian runs up 7.
Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
All right.
Back. Hello, back there. No, not me.
Sorry.
Wrong person.
Malco sees this is covered, so he just hangs back. Claire.
Let's get out of here. I'm leaving.
Wait, you're leaving?
Claire's leaving.
Over it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Have we been in this room?
I do not recall what it is.
I don't remember either.
Okay. I didn't think we looked in there.
We can peek in while we're here.
All right. That is it.
Tarwheel.
I'm going to look at Lasarker. I'm going to be like, I'm going to leave.
So when he moves his eyeball, Does the arrow move with it?
Gross. I'm totally picturing a Legend of Korra thing.
Sendia.
I will raise my sword. Actually, this time I will bring my sword to the side. I will be slashing this way.
Wow.
I will bring my sword over my shoulder. I will cry a prayer to Heronius, and I will swing it like this.
It's bad different. That.
I am being different. I should have just stuck with the normal way.
That was a five.
Yeah, well, at least it wasn't a one.
Yeah, it's a miss.
Yeah. Cute. Accidentally sliced that painting in half.
Me?
Yep. Yeah, it's you.
I'm tired of fighting. I feel like once they're not an immediate threat, moving on. I wanted to get out of that house, really. I didn't want to spend another second there.
Sacred Flame seems to work, man. Yeah.
And it's a cantrip?
It's a cantrip. Yeah. She can just throw that all day.
Sacred Flame.
Success.
1d8.
No, he succeeded. His
oh, he succeeded. Oh, never mind. Then you get nothing.
You get nothing.
You touch the fizzy lifting room, you get nothing.
Nice. All right, he's going to attack. You both missed. I guess he'll attack.
I mean, you haven't died yet, so.
I know.
Smacks you with his cudgel for 8 points of damage.
You're getting less alive. Great sound effects. I love it.
Yes. Stonian runs up, hits for some fairly heavy damage.
He's still alive?
He's still alive. He's hurting, though.
Mm.
Claire.
Me?
Yep.
I'm going to go in this room.
Okay.
He's like, oh, hi, fight. Goodbye, I'm going in the room.
You see...
I mean, there are four people around this table.
I know.
It was covered.
Yeah.
I'm joking.
You see, what would the word be for a wine cellar, basically? Mm. Except it's not a cellar. It's a room dedicated to bottles of fine drink.
Hmm. All right.
Okay.
And art as well.
Of course.
More.
Continuing the Lafont
okay.
appreciation. You're pretty sure that all these drinks are worth a fortune.
Okay, I grab two bottles.
Okay, two rare bottles of wine.
It was on the way out anyway. Just trying to check all the rooms. I uncover a wine cellar. I feel like Claire's probably in a state of mind where she wants to get drunk. So I'm gonna take a few bottles.
Hey Claire, what's in here?
Bunch of booze.
Sweet! I'm gonna grab a couple bottles too.
Grab two bottles.
Put that on my thing. Two rare wine.
We're like fighting that guy over there, and you guys just like.
You guys got this, right? Wine. You guys good?
You guys are good, right?
All
right,
cool.
So you guys are good.
Cynthia.
Wait, before Cindy goes, can I grab another one, open it up, and be like, Claire?
All right.
Sure.
Take a swig.
I'm going to drown my sorrows with booze.
It's
healthy. It tastes amazing.
Yeah.
I'm sure it does.
Don't drink it.
Oh, God. You throw the wine bottle in the bag. It's not like these wine bottles are made of this, like, super thin, like, sugar glass. You just, like, bump up against something and it's going to shatter. I mean, these are wine bottles. You just throw them in the bag. You carry in the wine bottles. They're clinking around. It's okay. It's just... That's kind of like us, you know, we're like, one night, we're like drinking with shh, 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 clink, clink, that's a whole other adventure right there.
Kira.
Sacred Flame.
Hold up a lighter.
I have to beat 13?
Yep.
Yeah,
success.
Do.
Ooh.
Maybe Sacred Flame isn't always the best
maybe
answer. 13 isn't that hard to roll over.
It's not that big of a deal, but you know. It's cantrip.
Stone Ann goes to work.
Ooh. In a good way or in a bad way?
We're about to find out.
Oh, that's good enough. And he cuts down Garg. And Garg just kind of falls down to the ground in a bloody heap. Not dead, but he's not moving either.
Dead enough. Well, we got to kill him to get XP points.
Don't necessarily.
No, well, you can get them by defeating.
Defeating.
Yeah, just defeating? Yeah. Okay.
All right, now what?
Well, now you're out of combat.
Cool. All right.
Okay.
Let's get out of here.
Let's do that. Let's get out of here. So we can all just kind of be like, is anybody going to kill this guy?
Somebody, yeah.
I'm not going to kill the guy.
Let's just.
We don't need to.
He's defeated, let's just
I mean,
go.
Maybe we should try and not, like, randomly murder people anymore. That's my new goal.
When... It's not random, but...
Yeah,
I mean,
he did attack
yeah.
me about 5 times.
So. He did, yeah. So we're leaving.
But when possible, maybe no
you guys
random
are dancing.
Murdering. All right, Claire, yeah. let's go find your sister.
So you go yeah. out into the courtyard, and standing there...
Is a dragon.
Is a woman with a white cloak, very pale skin.
Great.
Long, flowing black hair.
Misty.
It's the Blameless Maiden.
Oh. I knew it. Yeah.
You did not know that.
No, as soon as he said she
yes,
had.
Yes, you knew that.
As like, soon as he said there was a woman,
I knew well, no, it. I knew there was going to be the Blameless Maiden
no,
outside.
No, I didn't know that, but when he was
out,
a woman, I was
knew.
Like, that's the Blameless Maiden, isn't it? I didn't know before we stepped out, no way. But when he said there was a woman, I was like, Blameless Maiden, right?
I totally knew it.
Oh. I don't know what to do with that.
I'm hoping that she's maybe on our side. I'm hoping that maybe she's like, thanks for freeing me from this creepy dude. I'm not trapped in that painting anymore. I will grant you 3 wishes.
I don't know what's gonna happen. She could attack us. She could be like, yo, that's great, thanks. She could like give me the painting, which Malkos is probably gonna have a problem with. But I don't know. I don't know, we'll see.
Again, the romantic in Melanie would be like, oh, she's really the blameless woman. She's going to be a nice lady. Yeah, D&D is not a love story. Should be, though. Should be.
Be sure to like this video, because I hope you liked it. And we'd like to know if you liked it.
Share it with your friends. If you have comments, tell me how to use my powers and skills. That'd be helpful.
We've been getting a lot of really great comments, so I think you guys should totally keep that coming.
Make sure you tell all your friends to watch and tell them to subscribe so we can keep making this. We love making the show. It's a ton of fun for us, and we want to keep making it.
Thank you to Outlaw Moon Games and Toys for hosting our wonderful play session. Can I go home now? I'm ready to go home.